Тук-тук-тук.
In Ukraine's embattled east, Chaplain Yevhen Savchenko is with the military's 93rd Mechanized Brigade.
Христос воскрес!
Христос воскрес!
And on Sunday, he helped visibly tired troops at a temporary base in an undisclosed location mark the Orthodox Easter holiday.
Дуже багато людей можуть...
So many people can go to church and be at their homes in peace and freedom, he says, thanking the soldiers. This is the third wartime Easter commemoration since Russian forces invaded Ukraine. These soldiers only gave their first names. Yuri says he can't help but think of loved ones back home.
How do I feel? I want this war to be over as soon as possible, go home to my family and celebrate Easter with them, or with my comrades, but in a different setting.
In the absence of family, these soldiers enjoy traditional Easter pastries provided by acquaintances and volunteers. While most Western churches observed the Easter holiday at the end of March, Orthodox Christians, including those in Ukraine and Russia, mark it now. Fighting on the Eastern Front has worsened in recent weeks, particularly around the town of Chasiv Yar, all while Ukrainian troops wait for crucial U.S. military aid to beat back Moscow's advance. Meanwhile, several airstrikes hit the eastern city of Kharkiv on Sunday, leaving a woman dead and more than a dozen injured. In Kyiv, a local cathedral and folklore museum teamed up to honor the army's fight. President Volodymyr Zelensky called on Ukrainians to unite in prayer. People also marked the holiday in the war-struck town of Kostyantynivka, while knowing Russian troops are moving closer. I'm scared, but what can I do, says resident Svetlana. On Easter, I want to come here and get blessings for my Easter cake and eggs. Despite everything, it's a holiday.